Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel, and for today, I wanted to share to you the very reason kung bakit kailangan nating ipropagate yung ating mga succulents. So as you can see, itong mga succulents na ito are mostly my mother plants or the mother succulents, and from time to time, I have to propagate them kasi they won't be here forever, diba? So sometimes, parang they are healthy now, then magugulat na lang tayo the next day or after a few weeks or even years, bigla na lang silang namamatay. And just to give you an example, I have here some propagations ng mga succulents na yung mother plants nila ay namatay na. So in other words, if I didn't propagate yung mga succulents na yon, then I won't be having that succulent in our collection as of today. So unahin natin itong ating Echeveria imbricata, or we oftenly call it as the rose cabbage. Isa ito sa pinakamahirap na succulent na alagaan based on my experience. I'm not so sure of the reason kung bakit namatay yung pinaka-mother plant niya, pero probably because of overwatering or because of a fungal infection. So usually yung dalawang yun ang pinaka-reason kung bakit bigla na lang namamatay yung ating mga succulents, and good thing that I was able to propagate it. Next is this blue curls or the Shavayana blue frills. I'm not so sure about the right ID of this one, but just for a comparison, ito yung ating Shavayana pink frill. So for these pink frills, I don't have any problem, pero for the blue curls, nagkaroon ako ng problem sa kanyang pinaka mother plant. And probably it's because of overwatering. So mostly na ipapakita ko sa inyo, ang main cause of death ng kanilang mother plants is because of overwatering. That's the time when wala pa talagang roofing itong ating succulent table here. Kaya nababad talaga sa ulan yung iba nating mga succulents. We have this Echeveria laulensis. Ayan, isa ito sa mga magagandang succulents in our collection, pero again, because of overwatering, yung kanyang pinaka mother plant has eventually died. But itong propagation na to, mabilis lang natin itong palakihin kasi they are really fast growing succulents. Next would be this Aeonium bronze medal, and if you have watched yung care guide about this one, yung pinaka mother plant niya is very lush, and I think this one is just a cutting na naiwan, and so I don't know what happened to the bronze medal mother plant. Bigla na lang siyang namatay, and ito na lang yung naiwang bronze medal as of now in our collection. And dito nga sa pinakababa, may tumubong parang comic tome, and it looks like this when fully stressed. Although I do have a lot of comic tome dito sa ating collection, kaya we won't really be including this in our list. Next is this cotyledon pendens. Isa rin ito sa mga sobrang lush na succulent ko before, pero as of now, ito na lang ang natira, and I'm really hoping na masave pa natin itong ating cotyledon pendens. We also have this peperomia graveolens. Ayan, so I think right now, successful naman yung ating propagation, and since I have already moved this dito nga sa ating covered area, so far, so good naman yung kanyang growth. I didn't have any problem with it as of now. Next is this banana na tinatawag natin. Look at the tiny offsets sa pinakababa. And ang pinaka main problem naman ng ating banana succulent is yung fungus. Talagang lapitin sila ng fungus every cold season. So for example, now medyo lumalamig na ulit, and ayan, nag-start na ulit magkaroon ng powdery mildew yung kanyang leaf, and if we're not gonna be treating it right away, then definitely that's gonna be the main cause of its death. So same sila nung jelly beans, na talagang I don't have any jelly beans in our collection, even a single propagation talagang wala. So buti na lang meron tayong na propagate na banana. And of course, we have this nodulosa. Isa ito sa pinakamagandang or colorful succulent that you can have, but as you can see, talagang parang namamatay na itong propagation natin na ito. But I won't be giving up on this succulent. So I'm thinking of cutting yung stem niya sa pinakataas na part, kasi itong lower stem niya is medyo woody na siya. Kaya I think we don't be or we don't need yung bottom stem, but instead we will just be saving itong upper na part. And in any case na hindi natin siya ma-save, then I think I will just buy another one. And lastly, of course, itong ating pink butterflies. Ayan siya. It's a beautiful succulent. Pero I don't know, pag lumaki na sila, they started to lose leaves and eventually die. And lapitin rin ito ng fungus. Kaya yun yung pinaka-problem ko sa kanya. Ayan. So, I think yun yung pinaka-reason talaga kung bakit we have to propagate yung ating mga succulents para in any case na mamatay yung mother plant, we have a reserve already instead of buying a new one, diba? So, kumbaga, siguro second reason na lang why we have to propagate is para mas dumami pa yung ating mga succulents. But these days, I stopped propagating most of my succulents. So, kumbaga, I have to propagate lang yung mga succulents na medyo expensive or medyo rare na mahirap mahanap sa market. But for the rest, I think hindi ko na sila pinopropagate. And in any case na mamatay sila, I will just simply buy a new one. So that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You may also visit our Facebook page, A Desert Succulent PH.